Yeah. These are our fish. Eduardo Villablanca. You can see how beautiful and big they are.
Eduardo Villablanca uses some unusual tools when conducting his research. Transparent fish and cultivated miniature organs. With the help of these, he is working to understand a disease that affects millions of people worldwide. Inflammatory bowel disease, IBD.
Among the symptoms are diarrhea, fever, chronic pain in the abdomen. It's a disease that actually doesn't have a cure yet.
At times, the intestines become swollen and sore, impairing their ability to absorb nutrients and fluids. There are different types of conditions. In ulcerative colitis, it is the rectum and colon that are affected. And with Crohn's disease, the inflammation can occur anywhere along the gastrointestinal tract.
So guys, look at this. Talking about damage, I think that is not actually, these figures are not because of this.
40 to 60% of patients do not respond to treatment.
Into
regeneration. So CYP21 is induced.
And people that actually respond to treatment, they stop responding later on. So we clearly need to find new therapeutic target to treat the disease.
Hello, papá.
¿Cómo está, hijito?
Hola, papito. ¿Cómo está, papá? ¿Todo bien?
Todo bien, sí.
In Chile, Eduardo Villablanca's fascination with how the human body functions came to life. He grew up with a father who was a doctor.
I went to gastroscopies and I saw inside the gut, and it's fascinating.
And what hooked Eduardo Villablanca on research was...
So I just watched Jurassic Park at the time, and I was excited by the idea that you can recreate a whole dinosaur from the DNA, right?
Now, it wasn't exactly research on dinosaurs, but, well, on zebrafish. Eduardo Villablanca's research group has both striped and transparent.
Now you can see the internal organs, so you don't need to dissect the animal in order to visualize internal organs. You just can see from outside.
We really need peace in our gut. You know, we have microbiota, bacteria, food, many challenges that can come to our intestines and they can do damage.
What we eat, as well as substances in our environment, can create cracks in the gut's protective cell layer. Suddenly, the trillions of bacteria that live in there become visible to the immune system, which has to decide if the bacteria are friends or foe. The theory today is that if this happens often enough, a point is finally reached where the immune system begins to attack the gut and the good bacteria that live in there. The immune system has learned incorrectly and creates inflammation over and over again. The person has developed inflammatory bowel disease. In the hunt for substances that can trigger IBD, Eduardo's team looks at zebrafish, which are a few days old. The fish carry genes that increase the risk of developing IBD, and they are exposed to various substances to see which ones trigger inflammation in their intestines.
We always say that the gene loads the gun, but the environment pulls the trigger. We need to do this.
But at the same time that Eduardo tries to understand the exact reason why some people get IBD while others don't, he also wants to develop medications for those who are already afflicted. This is where the organoids come in, cultured miniature guts.
An organoid is something that we use in the lab to mimic what happens in the gut.
In these mini intestines, new drugs against IBD are being tested. which have been developed with the help of research on, among other things, the zebrafish.
Our goal is to test drugs. So we have identified pathways. We can manipulate some pathways, we can put some drugs, and we can promote tissue repair in a more efficient manner.
The new medicine will speed up healing in the intestines. If damage caused by what we ingest, by the environment or inflammation heals faster, the intestinal contents are not exposed to the immune system for as long. Then, the immune system does not have time to react so strongly and does not attack the intestine. The hope is then that the inflammation decreases and that the patient will be cured from IBD.
Every time I talk to my father, he asks me, so what do you discover now? Or have you published? Our ultimate goal in the lab is to identify new mechanism, new pathway, new target to understand better this disease. And we are very close to use this in patients. Okay, papito, un besito.
Chao.
Yo también. Chao.